following the solar system out to the observatory. Just another morning on the deck of the observatory. A few years ago, we started beginning every day with movement. We call it morning energize. I started coming down here after breakfast with students and doing a little bit of Tai Chi on the beach. More recently, we started doing, or I should say, restarted doing a quiet period every day. Few minutes of mindfulness, practicing awareness. Sometimes it's also practicing community, interconnectedness. But this is such a good place to practice awareness. Noticing our breath. Noticing our place. Blue Jays calling. Like Michigan whispering. Family mergansers paddling by. clouds, bugs. To be centered in the world, we have to know where we are in the world. We have to know where we are in ourselves. About Norm Wheeler out here on this deck reading Gary Snyder. Reading Edward Abbey. Hey Duke lived out on this deck, out on this bed, this beach. It's almost summer solstice now, but I'm thinking of the generations of Leelanau seniors who trekked through the snowdrifts to come out here for senior English. All the students who sat out here and read Allen Ginsberg and wrote their own howl. You got to know where you are in yourself. Think about the decades of Christian Science students who had a quiet period every day to read, to think. And all the people who have had to memorize at least one poem. And then get up before the whole school and read it for poetry out loud. Shared by students and staff, quiet period, morning meeting. And this one by William Stafford. A ritual to read to each other. If you don't know the kind of person I am, and I don't know the kind of person you are, then a pattern that others made may prevail in the world, and following the wrong God home, we may miss our star. For there's many a small betrayal in the mind, a shrug that lets the fragile sequence break, sending with shouts the horrible errors of childhood storming out to play through the broken dike. And as elephants parade, holding each elephant's tail, but if one wanders, the circus won't find the park. I call it cruel, and maybe the root of all cruelty, to know what happens, but not recognize the fact. And so I appeal to a voice, to something shadowy, a remote, important region in all who talk. Though we could fool each other, we should consider, lest the parade of our mutual life get lost in the dark. For it is important that awake people be awake, or a breaking line may discourage them back to sleep. The signals we give, yes, no, or maybe, should be clear, for the darkness around us is deep.